Thank you. There's a basic question that seems to trouble a good many people today, and that is, what am I doing with my life? In former times, people had definite, generally accepted answers to this question. But today, there seems to be a mixture of confused ideas. A good many people might answer this way: to play all you can, eat all you can, drink all you can, laugh all you can, socialize all you can, have as many sensory satisfactions as you can, and that's that. Theirs is a modernized version of the old adage, eat, drink, and be merry, for tomorrow you may die. I'd like to discuss another philosophy right after this word. Eat, drink, and be merry is just one way of expressing a whole range of philosophies, the basis of which is indolence. There are others whose thinking goes, as long as I'm comfortable, that's the main thing. So I'll take it as easy as I can and avoid getting excited. I won't let things upset or pressure me, and I won't let conditions around me get under my skin. I'll just float with the tide. This is a rather indolent philosophy. And then there are the gifted people with some special talent who rise to the top of their fields. Sometimes they accumulate wealth and fame, and that's all they bother about, having no concern for anything else or anybody. But there are other, more thoughtful people. They think there must be some depth to life, some reality more than may be evident, some deeper meaning, and they propose to find it. They take the qualities of life and use these to the full for the good of others. They invest their powers right up to the limit. If you think you weren't given much, that certainly doesn't relieve you of the responsibility of using what you do have in making this a better world. The late Albert Schweitzer had it about right. He said, "The only ones among you who will be really happy are those who will have sought and found how to serve." When I graduated from college, my father said, "I've done all I can for you. Now go on out and amount to something. I think you've got something in you, so take what you've got and use it." And he clapped me on the back and punched me in the chest. And he added, "Take what little you've got and do something to help make it a better world." Well, what he said got to me. And ever since, I've been troubled periodically by the question, what am I doing with my life? It's a very good question to be troubled by.